Hi, I'm Jim Ikram, Artistic Director for the Theater Program. Thank you for joining us for our fourth Zoom stage production. Now, this might be the last time we do it this way because we're hoping to be back in the beautiful Osterman Theater this fall of 2021, and we hope you'll come back and join us for another exciting season of live theater. This is an original play by CCC student Muriel LeMay titled Dartwood. Now, Muriel wrote this play while she was a student in Sue Mock's playwriting class. She says she drew her inspiration from her love of 19th century vampire literature with a little bit of Buffy the Vampire Slayer sprinkled in there. Thank you, Muriel, for trusting us to do your play. And thank you to everyone who contributed to this play. Our very talented cast of students and one community member, Sue Mock, the English faculty member I mentioned, our administrative assistant, Jennifer Jett, our scenic and lighting designer, Chris Witten, our costumer, Gina Piva, and last but not least, Dante Ross, our wizard of editing. Dante is going to be moving to the Garden State, New Jersey this summer. He and all his contributions to the theater program will be sorely missed, and so I want to take a second to thank Dante for all he's done for us the past few years and to wish him the best of the luck in his future endeavors. Now, sit back, grab a snack and your favorite beverage, and enjoy Dartwood. But remember, if you're a vampire, you never drink wine. Snack. I'll be back after the show to tell you how you can support our program. Enjoy.
Do you know if anything happened last night?
Something happened?
Well, I'm not exactly.
The last time the Knights of Bannerville went missing, you spoke of experiencing heart palpitations, insomnia, slight headache, quote, strange discomfort on the whole skin as if something were crawling across it, end quote. Were these symptoms present again?
No, I don't know that.
No, then how could you tell if...
I couldn't. Nothing happened. I was just checking with you to make sure.
Why would you ever need to check in with me? If something did happen, certainly you'd be the first to... Ah.
What?
You're looking for something to do, aren't you?
Well, yes.
You must make friends, Violet. Your only joy in life cannot be in ghastly, blood-sucking things.
Your only joy in life is in ghastly, blood-sucking things.
That is not true. I also find joy in ghastly things, which do not suck blood. You must at least make an effort.
I can't just make an effort. It isn't so simple.
How do you know if you've not tried?
I have tried. We're not discussing this.
If anything does happen, I suppose you'll tell me. I've nothing to report presently, but then you already knew that. And it's just that it needn't be so difficult for you. I mean, I'm just concerned is all, if you're unhappy in any way.
You needn't be, and I'm perfectly fine. I heard she got kicked out of 6 different schools. I heard she got kicked out for fighting. I've heard she's brutal.
I heard she tried to kill someone.
She would have been arrested for that, Sarah, not expelled.
You know, she's kind of small. I wonder how she managed to win all those fights. Do you suppose she's just very strong and we can't tell on account of her size? Do you suppose she used that as a trick?
I've heard she's got knives. Multiple knives.
Oh, well, that would help in a fight for certain, then. Perhaps she's not strong at all, but her skirt is just lined with knives. So other girls couldn't fight back for fear of catching on one and slicing themselves right open. Violet? Violet? Violet!
What?
Have you heard about the new girl? She got expelled from the last school for setting a fire. She burnt a whole room to a crisp. She told Mary that herself.
Fascinating.
And I heard from Lucy that Lizzie heard from Edith, heard from Edith, heard from that girl Maud's been rooming with, that she tried to kill someone.
I don't trust Lucy. She exaggerates, though. That one cannot be true. Mary, Sarah, not that this isn't a perfectly enthralling conversation, but we all really have things we ought to be finishing up, don't we?
I should know better than to try to talk to you about anything interesting at all. You're such a dreadful bore, Violet. I was only trying to be friendly.
I know. I think she's a lost cause.
I should say so.
You are 30 minutes late, Miss Hayward.
Yes, well, I'm here now, aren't I?
You've not been at this institution 2 weeks, and you are already developing a very worrying pattern of absences. Tomorrow, you will attend, and you will be on time. Do I make myself clear?
Quite. What page are we on?
Starts at 36.
Thanks. Christ, this is dull. Does it get any better?
I would know that, wouldn't I? If I could finish, and I could finish if I could stop being interrupted.
Kind of stupid though, isn't it?
It's not stupid.
It's not interesting.
Did you really tell poor Sarah that she set a fire?
How do you know that I didn't?
I'm not an idiot. I think it's absurd to lie to all those girls. So what? So they'll frighten and you can feel superior? I think you're self-obsessed.
I think you're making wild assumptions based on very little information.
Haven't you work to be doing?
Haven't you?
Very normal.
Who are you? What are you doing out here?
Alice Haywood. So very pleased to make your acquaintance. I'd ask you the same, but seeing as you just tried to kill me, I think I have my answer.
You! So, you know about, but you're not one of them. But you know!
What? Did you think you were the only person in the world who knows? The only one special enough to?
No! No, Cluster told me she'd known others like me. And I gathered as much. I thought I was the only one here.
Well, I suppose you were. Surprise!
I couldn't sleep. That's why I came out. Sorry, I suppose, for the attacking. It's only the out. I can feel it. Something bad is going to happen.
Or already has done. Same reason I'm here anyway. That itch.
I've always considered it. It's a duty.
Right.
What's with the
improvisation? Had a knife before. Confiscated. Don't let you keep anything once they've caught you burning things up.
You really set a fire?
Long story.
Good. I don't care. What?
I've not done anything to you.
You haven't. Doesn't mean I have to be fond of you.
I get the feeling that you're not fond of anyone. Not doing you great favors, is it?
Beg pardon?
Not really endearing you to anyone to act all above.
You don't know me, and I shan't be taking advice from someone who...
What the hell are you? What are you doing?
There's no... They're gone!
I do have fully functioning eyes, but thank you. Keen on getting eaten, are you?
I could have... Somebody has died. Surely you realize that.
Dead or the other thing.
And I could have... If you hadn't.
Oh, right. If I hadn't. Have you ever killed one? Have you ever even seen one? Actually seen one in person? Because it's not the same thing as just feeling them there.
Yes, I've seen one.
Oh. They're not going to politely wait for you to cut off their heads. I'm going back.
Have you?
Done what?
Killed one?
Ah, oh, Christ! You startled me. Wasn't expecting. Something happened last night, didn't it? I knew it when I'd heard that.
Yes. Somebody was abducted or killed or something. And I was going to stop it, but then... What did you hear?
Can't remember the name, but hasn't shown in any classes all day and hasn't been seen anywhere by her roommate since last night. Apparently, she had laid the correspondence with some fellow. All the letters were found under the mattress, so everyone thinks she's gone off and eloped or something stupid like that. But I knew it.
Yes, well, I've no idea what happened to her because I was going to, but then this girl was there, and she's another one of whatever it is that I am, Alice Haywood.
This is wonderful news.
This is not wonderful news. Somebody has died, probably.
Oh, yeah, well, you're right. That's certainly not wonderful news. Condolences to the family and all that. But I should really like to meet with this girl. I mean, a larger sample size would be delightful.
Well, I'm not delighted. She mucked the whole thing up and then had the nerve to act as if she's so learned, as if she's not just some ridiculous, affected, arsonist delinquent.
Arsonist?
Yes. She thinks she's so above it all, and she's out of her mind. She's unhinged.
Well, I think I should like to meet with her. I don't suppose you've tried being friendly, have you?
How should... Are you joking?
Well, I think this could be a very good opportunity for you, is all.
What?
You did know you fancy only one. Yeah, I mean, I did tell you, didn't I? Oh dear, did I not?
Yes, yes, you did. I know. It's only...
Then really, I don't see why this is upsetting for you. It isn't healthy to spend all your time alone. You have a lot in common, probably. So fraternize!
I really don't think you understand.
Fraternize. We have a thing to be done now. We can't afford personal problems coming in the way of things. And I think if what I think is happening is happening, it may be a bit inconvenient to handle. So...
What does that mean?
Well, I mean, I don't know necessarily just yet. Not enough data to work with to reasonably draw conclusions at this point. But I will, one way or another, soon.
That's not comforting.
I'll figure out whatever I am to figure out, and we will handle it, I'm sure. In any way, just be pleasant or something, I don't know. Just long enough that this can be dealt with. Then you may carry on hating this girl to your heart's content. Perhaps she isn't so quite terrible as you think. In any event, just for the time being, please.
Once you meet her, you will understand, and I will be vindicated, and I will laugh.
Well, I think that scenario is, I suppose, one of several reasonably possible outcomes. Just if you could try, even a very little.
Well, I reserve the right to make no promises whatsoever.
That's a start.
What are you doing here?
I've been moved. The girl I was rooming with came down with some mysterious form of anemia. And apparently you've no roommate.
Yes, no.
What?
Nothing. By mysterious form of anemia, do you mean, well...
Someone found her outside on an observation lesson, drained of blood. So I should assume, yes.
She's still alive, but not. She's not one of them, is she?
No, seems about almost dead, though. Probably going to turn sooner or later.
Lovely. And of course she had a room with you.
I'm not too thrilled either. Let's hope you don't kill me in my sleep.
I would never... I thought you were one of those creatures. I would never do that.
How could I be? You'd already seen me in broad daylight the same day. That doesn't even make any sense.
It was a very stressful night.
Mm-hmm. How do you even get a room to yourself?
Why do you care?
Jesus Christ, I was just wondering.
Was ill for a bit when I was younger. Didn't die, obviously, but convinced everyone I needed extended solitude to recover. Nobody ever followed up on it.
Really? They believed you?
They didn't question it.
I thought you'd be too good to lie.
Well, you thought wrong.
Yes, I did.
Who is she?
Who?
Your former roommate.
Mary... starts the D, I think. Can't remember.
Dixon?
Yeah. Did you know her?
Not personally, no. Do you think there's any way to reverse it?
I've no idea. I should think not.
Suppose I'll meet with Miss Klossner tomorrow, or she'll probably meet with me.
Sorry, who?
German teacher.
The weird one?
That'd be her, yes. She's not like us. She's just very passionate about her studies. It's getting late.
It is.
I'm going to put out the candle.
All right.
Oh.
good you're here. I know it's only been a few minutes, but I did ask for you here too. And it is 2:05 at present, and I was getting worried a bit. But anyway, the girls, it was found and returned, I presume you?
Yes.
Well, she's been bitten, obviously, and drained, but hasn't died as of now, so I'm not entirely sure what... Oh, forgive me. You must be on Alice. Wilhelmina Klosner, how do you do?
Are you all right?
Yes. Perfectly fine.
You seem a bit frazzled, is all.
Frazzling situation a bit. I have everything under control, or will have done shortly. But it is also kind of exciting, isn't it? Not a dying girl, but that's the frazzling part. But what I meant was never mind.
Is she just going to die, or
she's Well, going to come back.
And do you know if there's any way to reverse it?
I've heard of one account in somewhere Slavic, I think, a few years back, something with communion bread. It's been done before, but isn't common practice as far as I know.
Is it? Do we know if it can be replicated? I mean, I reckon we're just going to do what one generally does in situations such as these.
I don't want to kill her!
Would you prefer she becomes a creature then? You didn't know her, and I don't think you're going to have a choice.
Yesterday, you said that something inconvenient might be happening. Is that happening?
Most probably yes, or something of the sort, yeah.
May I ask what on earth both of you are talking about?
There is a root to this problem, obviously, and well, I've kept correspondence with a number of colleagues over the past few months, and collectively, we've observed a trend. There's been a string of attacks, mostly in the countryside, but with a few exceptions, all of which can be eventually traced back to a sort of folkloric figure from Hungary, who has been reanimated since at least the early 17th century. Some theorize she's this lost battery countess, but I think that's just fanciful. I mean, I wasn't sure she actually existed at all until recently, because she's not been active since the 1770s. But as you may infer from all that, she isn't particularly easy to kill.
That does sound remarkably inconvenient.
Indeed.
What are we going to do?
That depends on several factors, the first of which being what we are to do about Mary.
What would we need to do to reverse it?
We would need to... Perform an exorcism, and that's wherein the trouble lies. She hasn't much time left, certainly not enough for me to get the priest out.
There must be something we can do. We could do it, couldn't we?
We're not priests, are we?
We could, I suppose we could try. I don't know. It's something.
We don't even know if it would work.
What else are we to do? Any brilliant insights? So, exorcism then.
I suppose, yeah. Good Lord. Princeps gloriosissime celestis militiae, Sancte Michael Arcangele, defende nos in proelio adversus principes et potestates, Aversus mundi! Rectores tenebrarum harum contra spiritalia nequitiae in celestibus. Veni in auxilium hominum quos Deus. Ad imaginem similitudinis suae fecit. Etta tirannide diaboli emicretio magno, te custodum et patronum sancta. Veneratur ecclesia, tibi tradidit.
Is it supposed to happen like that?
Tibi tradidit! God damn it!
I don't reckon.
I don't know. I don't understand what. And it was working, wasn't it? Or something was happening for a moment, then nothing again.
Couldn't have anything to do with our not being priests, could it?
I followed everything I was supposed to follow. I don't understand why it started, then stopped like that, and at random. There was no discernible pattern, nothing to indicate anything.
Can we try again?
What good is that going to do? It didn't work the first time.
What we need to do is find out what went wrong. There's obviously there's a problem, and problems have causes, generally speaking, and fix it. Simple, very simple.
But you said there was no pattern, no explanation. How we considered that maybe it just didn't work?
That's true. I mean, that's an option, yeah.
So that's it then?
Well,
what?
Technically speaking, no.
What does that mean?
Mary is the problem, not the cause. We can stop the proverbial bleeding, or we can attempt to stitch up the proverbial wound. If you follow.
I don't follow.
We stake Mary, or we attempt to deal with the Countess.
We deal with the Countess.
Are you out of your mind? She'll kill us. There's no way she won't kill us.
It doesn't feel right, just waiting around for her to die like that.
None of it feels right. They're vampires.
It'll happen again, though. Nothing will change fundamentally, and more people will die. I'll do it myself if neither of you will.
That is a genuinely horrible idea.
While it does have a point, one institution can only cover up so many missing persons cases before things start looking suspicious.
What?
In any case, if there's a way she won't turn, we are probably obligated to pursue it. So.
Well, good to know both of you are out of your bloody minds. Had I known ahead of time I was going to be among mad people, I wouldn't have tagged along for this little experiment.
I never asked you to tag along in the first place. And nobody needs you here if you really are so...
Pardon. But we really ought to focus on the issue at hand, oughtn't we?
Sorry.
We will just make an attempt, won't we? We can make an attempt.
An attempt? Like the one we just made?
Not a load of other options, are there?
So what does an attempt look like then?
A moment. Human blood.
You know, I'm not even going to ask.
What are we going to do with that?
Someone is going to need to draw the thing to us. I prefer not to involve eyes of you, given your age, but you have certain sensitivities that I do not. And it is important that this does not fail completely. You are not doing the staking.
Why don't I get to do the staking?
The goal was to prevent more children from dying, was it not?
And the beheading?
Beheading by oneself is very difficult, terribly difficult. So I'll allow collaboration.
It's true. It takes a great deal of time and is altogether unpleasant.
How do you know that?
Wickham.
You were at Wickham? How'd you end up here? You're even an orphan.
Illegitimate. Mother died at childbirth. You?
Typhoid.
Huh. Bit less dramatic.
A bit, yes.
You are going to draw this sigil with the blood at the location Mary was found. We know our countess is in the area, so it's just a matter of if she'll decide to pay us a visit or not. You'll both, of course, take protective measures so as not to actually die. Perhaps Alice will do the staking.
What? Why?
Just considering her prior experience and all, it might be safer. Not that any of this is safe, but relatively speaking.
So I bet.
Well, that's one way of putting it.
What other way is there to put it?
You're serving an important function.
Doesn't really feel like it.
It's the truth. I'll be there the whole time. If anything goes wrong, I'll intervene.
You?
Fine.
Okay.
This is the worst night we could have done this.
Not ideal conditions, no.
There's no way it'll work.
You're in high spirits. Might let up, though, eventually.
Doubtful.
Well, we do have the entire night.
I should hope not. There. Done.
Oh! What do you do now?
Wait, I suppose. Hope it doesn't wash away in the deluge.
Thrills of monster hunting. Guess I thought, don't know, maybe she'd pop up out of the ground or something. Got you, just now.
You didn't.
I did.
Nearly. Doesn't count.
Oh no, of course not. Was that?
I don't know.
I think it was just...
Oh!
Oh no!
What do we do now? Didn't Miss Costner say she'd intervene?
She did! I don't!
What do we do?
I don't know!
Give me the stake!
What?
Give me the stake!
We should... Miss Costner!
Give me the stake!
I'm not going to give you the stake! Let go! God damn it!
That was a disaster.
Indeed!
So, beheading.
That went well.
Shut up!
We should talk about it, probably.
It's done with. We dealt with it. Nothing to talk about.
Yes, but you did do remarkably badly, though.
I know!
So just out of curiosity, why did you think wrestling the stake from me would be a good idea? Whilst, you know, a blood-sucking demon was intent on eating us?
I panicked! I don't know.
Oh, right. You panicked. All you had to do was let me do the stabbing bit. That was all.
I know.
But you didn't.
No, it was stupid.
It was.
It was very stupid.
Quite.
And I shouldn't have. I'm sorry.
Well, good to know we've come to a common understanding on that then.
I think it's just...
What?
It's just, you're so sure of yourself. And I guess I just wish I had that.
Oh, that's actually nice.
And I'm sorry for all of it. Can we make a truce?
You make it all sound very dramatic.
I mean, it would probably be in both of our best interests to work together moving forward, considering there will be more vampires.
There will.
And I think...
What?
Nothing.
What?
I think you're the closest thing I've ever had to a friend.
Oh, are we friends?
I wouldn't know.
Me either.
Bit pathetic, isn't it?
It is a bit, yeah. Would you like a...
No. That was weird.
It was.
Won't be trying that again.
No.
Jim Ikram, Artistic Director of the Theater Program, here again. If you would like to make a contribution to our Theater Program Fund for Excellence, please follow the link you see on your screen now. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next year in the Osterman Theater. Bye for now.